Hey, what's up, guys? Mario back again with another trade video. How are you guys doing today? Today, I'm going to go over a day trade that I did make on NIO today, NIO stock. But I also want to kind of cover why I'm very bullish on this company, why I actually bought more stock in my long-term portfolio in NIO, and kind of go over the sentiment, the bullish sentiment, some of the news, the fundamentals, and why that is important. So don't forget to smash that like button, subscribe to this channel. As a reminder, guys, these videos are for learning and entertainment purposes. All right, let's get started. Let me share my screen. Okay. So I kind of want to show you guys first the chart, the daily chart of NIO and what is going on. If you look at the yearly chart, it's just had a really amazing trend. And it went through a consolidation period since, let's say, I believe like early November, and it finally broke out in this year, actually. Actually, it started breaking out the end of December, and this year it looks like that trend is going to continue. So overall, NIO has been having a really good year last year. And looking at the trends and what's happening with the electronic vehicle or the EV sector, doesn't look like it's gonna end. Now I did day trade it, so I kind of want to go over the day trade. And the reason why I day trade is because yesterday had a pretty big move and some volume, and it was an important news actually, and it was based on the delivery dates. So NIO, if you look at the news right here, NIO provides December fourth quarter and full year 2020 delivery update. NIO delivered 7,000 vehicles in December 2020. This is just in 1 month, an increase of 121% year over year. That is huge. NIO delivered 17,353 vehicles in 3 months ended December 2020. So in one quarter, they delivered 17,353 vehicles, an increase of 111% year over year. And then NIO delivered 43,728 vehicles in 2020, an increase of 112% year over year. So this is huge, guys. This is very, very huge. Now, cumulative deliveries of ES8, ES6, and ESC6 on December 31st, 2020, reached 75,641 vehicles. So all the vehicles that they've sold since the company started has already reached 75,000. This is just the start. So it looks like they exceeded and they beat their delivery numbers. And overall, of course, that caused some huge volume yesterday above the average volume. It broke out of this wedge, this bull flag. And I actually called it a couple of days ago last week that I went long because the trend was continuing and there was money flow coming in. So I decided to add it here on December 30th. And I actually added again yesterday on the 4th on the continuation of the trend. It broke out of this 50 level. Very, very important level, and a gap and with big volume. So I think this thing could trend, break 60, even more. I think it could probably go to like 70, 80, even 100 if you hold for a long term. But again, this is more my thoughts. So in terms of the day trade, I did day traded it today. It was a low-hanging fruit, long and continuation of the trend. So looking for a second day move of yesterday's move. So looking at the intraday charts, it was a little bit tricky today. And the reason why is because coming in when usually when it comes to second day moves, low hanging fruit longs, I like to kind of buy on the pullbacks to the midpoint. Unfortunately, the market gapped down. There was some volatility related to the Georgia Senate race off, election race off, and the market gapped down and NIO came with it. So it started to sell below the midpoint. So I couldn't use the midpoint to kind of get in. I actually did like this 52 level. It had a lot of open interest and a lot of volume in the options. So I felt like that was going to hold and trend pre-market. So I decided to kind of get in. I get in around 52.7. I added when the trend kind of confirmed, but it couldn't break above the volume weighted average price, this purple trend line, and it kind of sold off. And I decided to kind of cut off my trade once it made a new low, or it broke out of this higher low right here. So once it broke off this level right here, I decided to get out because it kind of breaks off the trend. So the trend did not help. Now, I looking back at it, I think the best thing I could have done is just wait and use the S1 pivot level, which is this green line right here, to kind of get in substitution of the midpoint. This is our outer lines. And the reason why is because these pivot points tend to help very well. Even though it did break below that, if I would have gotten in at the S1, risking maybe 50, which is another important options level, even below that, I would have still done actually pretty good trade, because as soon as when the market opened, it started to kind of it opened weak. Actually, looked like it was going to kind of break 5250. And I was even thinking about adding, okay, if it breaks 5250 and even the midpoint, I'm actually go back in. But it actually, you know, it opened weak. It pretty much took off all these traders, opened weak, sold off, and tested the S1 pivot. I almost hit 5040, this level, the 50s level, and then actually kind of reclaimed the volume weighted average price. And it would have been a nice trade if I would have just got in S1 pivot and sold around 5250s. That would have been actually an easier trade, a smarter trade. Now, the reason why I didn't trade it is because I actually put a entry for S2 because I felt that it was a possibility if the market opened very, very weak because of what was happening with the volatility. I really actually felt that S2 pivot level was a possibility it could hit. So that's the reason why I actually put my entry at S2 pivot, which is 49, around 49 level, instead of S1. But it held and it bounced off. So I missed that opportunity. So it is what it is, guys. There was actually another opportunity after the zombie hour times. It actually tested S1 again and it started to trend again. So that could have been another entry for those of you traders who like to enter in pivot levels, because it actually ended up trending pretty well. And it actually went green for a little bit. Now it's kind of testing that green area. But overall, guys, even though, again, day trading, that's the reason why day trading is a little bit difficult, because getting in at the right levels, it could be difficult. Pivots for me tend to work best. That's why I prefer to enter in pivots, even though sometimes I do tend to enter in lines depending on what the price action is. But overall, I notice that pivots tend to hold very, very well. Now, going over the fundamentals of what's happening with NIO and why I'm also very, very bullish, besides them having this press release that they hit all their delivery numbers, there's a bigger picture to it, guys. There's something bigger happening, and it has to do with the European Union and China reach investment agreement, trade agreement. So pretty much the European Union and China reach an agreement in principle on investment. So pretty much they're going to invest in each other. So China is going to invest in companies or products in the in European Union, and then European Union is going to be investing in company products from China. So that a huge sector that's going to benefit from that, especially in China, is going to be the electronic vehicles sector, like electronic cars. You know, like NIO, companies like NIO. Now, if you look at this article, NIO to expand to Europe in 2021. So this recent European Union and also China trade deal is going to benefit companies like NIO. It's going to make it easier for NIO to sell their cars to the European Union. And the European Union is one of the biggest markets outside of China for NIO. So for them, it's huge. It's huge. So if you think about it, in the next 5 to 10 years, of what's going to happen, I mean, it just goes to show, guys, that, you know, there's a lot of potential for growth in NIO. And again, they just started. You know, there's some of the bigger car manufacturers out there, like some of these other, you know, like Toyota and other car manufacturers. They sell millions of cars. And in the future, especially because of regulation, especially in the European Union, where a lot of countries in the European Union have set requirements where by 2030, every new company manufacturing that produces a car, it has to be electronic. So when you really think about it, NIO is going to be one of the companies that's going to benefit, especially with this European trade agreement. So I hope you guys learned something from this video, guys. Again, I'm very, very bullish on it. I do own a long-term position on NIO. I did actually add more after I saw the announcement of the delivery numbers and they hit the numbers. Now, I am a long-term investor. As a reminder, guys, this video, I'm not a financial advisor. I'm not a registered financial advisor. These videos are for learning and entertainment purposes. Now, don't forget to smash that like button, subscribe to this channel below. If you have questions about anything regarding NIO or electronic vehicle sector, Tesla, et cetera, please comment below, and I'll be more than happy to answer your questions. All right, guys, have a good one, guys. Take care. See you at the next time. Have a good one.